Hello friends, welcome to Learn It By Fun. So we are continuing with our lecture on compiler design. So today's point of discussion will be SLR parser. So as we know, SLR stands for simple LR parser. Okay. So our today's point of discussion is, we are given with this grammar with six number of productions. Okay, where E is the start symbol and we have the last production F derives ID. Okay. So with the help of this production, we have to design or we have to construct the SLR parse table. Okay. So now proceed. So step one, we need to augment the grammar. Okay. What does it, that this augmentation means? Okay. So this augmentation simply means that we are going to add one extra production to the given set of production. Okay. So in our grammar, we are going to add one extra production, that is of the form E dash derives E, where E is the start symbol. Okay. Where E is the start symbol. This is the only point we have to cover in this augmented grammar. Okay. That E dash derives E, that where E is the start symbol, and rest productions will remain the same. So after first step, we have the seven number of productions. Okay. Now, the output of this step 1, okay, will be given to the input of step 2. Okay. So step 2. So in step 2, what you need to do, you have to write every production in this form. Okay. Dot E. It simply means that you are going to add a dot. What does this dot is? Dot is a closure sign. Okay. So you are going to add a dot to the extreme left of every right hand side of every production. Okay. So you just add a dot sign to the left, to the extreme left of the right hand side of every production given in your grammar after the augmented grammar. Okay. So we are going to do the same thing. E plus T here augment, then here augment, then you need to, okay, you need to have a dot before every production. So we are doing the same thing. So let me see, T derives dot F, okay, F derives dot E within bracket, or F derives dot ID. Okay, so this is the after the result. Okay, after the step 2, we have the following result. Okay, that in each production, what we did after the augmented grammar, in each production to the right hand side, okay, and to the extreme left of the right hand side, what we did, we have just added a dot or a closure sign to each of the production. Okay, so now we are going to move to step 3. Okay, so after step 2, this is the result. Okay, so we are now going to move to step 3. Okay, so in step 3, we are going to design a DFA. Okay, what does this DFA is? We have already read this DFA in your finite automata, where suppose you have two states A and state B. Okay, so from state A to state B, you can only move with a single input, okay, to only one state. For example, for this example, we are moving with a transition of A from state A to state B. Okay, but if we are going to move to state C with the same transition, this is not possible in DFA. So we are going to maintain this same property in construction of the DFA here. Now, the output of the second step 2 will act as the initial state of the designing of a DFA. Okay, so this will be our initial state of DFA. Now, this dot means that we have not scanned any of the symbol, so that priorly we are keeping this dot to the extreme left, because one by one we are going to or have a scanning. Okay, when we are going to see or scan the symbol, then we will move this dot to the right. Okay, now suppose we have seen this E, okay, or we have scanned this E. So when we have scanned this E, it means that the production E derives, so it will turn to E dot. Okay, it means that this production has stopped its completion, okay, or scanning. Now in this production also, in production number 2, we can see that when we are going to scan E, or when we are going to have a shift of E, then we can do this also. So E derives E dot plus D. This much for this state. Okay. Now we have covered these two productions. Now further moving on, when we are going to move this shift or T, okay, when we are going to shift this T, what we will get? We will get E derives T dot. T dot means dot is at the end. It means that we have successfully scanned this production. Okay. Now, after this, you have another production. Okay. So T derives T dot star F. This much for this state. Okay. Now, when you are going to scan this F, okay, so you have only one production for F. So this will be the result. Okay, now the very important point, friends, when we are going to scan this left parenthesis, okay, so what we will get? We will get F derives, as we have scanned this left parenthesis, so left parenthesis dot E and right parenthesis. So here is a very important point. When you have after dot, when you have a non-terminal, so you need to write or expand that non-terminal with the possible production value. Okay, so here we need to just replace this E with the given set of productions. Okay, here we have dot E plus T, and here we have E derives dot T. Okay, now this is also in the form where after dot we have a non-terminal, so we need to expand this also. So what we will get? T star F, and T will produce dot F. So this much for this state. Okay, we can also expand this, okay, we can also expand this further by having, let us see what we can do for F. Okay, for F we have dot, okay, and for this F also we have dot ID. So we can have all possible values for this production. So this was the main concern regarding the design of a DFA. Okay, so after this you have ID left. Okay, so when you are going to scan this ID, you are having this ID dot. Okay, so this is all about your first step. Okay, now for moving to scan this next symbol. Okay, so this production has successfully completed this execution. Now we are going to focus on this production. So after dot we have plus. So when we are going to scan this plus, what we will get? E derives E plus dot T. So after dot we have T, that is non-terminal, so we need to expand this. So T will give you dot T star F, and T will also give you here dot F. Now you need to expand this dot F also. So this dot F will give you F, okay, and F will also give you dot ID. So this much. Okay, now we are going to expand this. Okay, so when we are going to expand this, E derives T dot, it means it has successfully compiled. Now T derives T dot star F. So after dot we have a star, so we are going to scan this star. So when we are going to scan this star, what we will get? We will get T derives T star dot f. Okay, so when we are going to replace this f, because after dot this is a non-terminal, so when we are going to replace this f, what we will get? We will get f derives dot e and f derives id. Okay, this much. Now we need not to process this because it is already successfully compiled. Okay, now we are going to focus on this production, okay, or this state. Now f derives here within bracket e, okay, when after dot when we are going to scan this e, okay, then what we will get? F derives e dot and bracket close. Okay, here we also have the same set of operation, so e derives e dot plus d. Okay, so this much. Now when you are going to have e derives dot d, it means that after this step you will be having e derives t dot. So here we have e derives t dot, and we also have t dot star f. So with the transition of t, okay, with the transition of t, we can reach this state. Okay, now t derives dot f or t derives dot f, this can be possible when we have a transition from this state to this state. Okay, and simply f derives your dot e. Okay, so this remains the same, this is already repeated, so we need not to write this. Okay, and f derives id, it means that with the transition of id, okay, this is already repeated, so we are not including this, and f derives dot id, it means that with the transition of id, okay, we can reach to this state. So here for f derives id, we have a transition with id to this, with id, okay, let me write it correctly, with id we can move from this state to this state. Okay, we have left one production also, that is f derives dot e within bracket. Okay, so when we are going to scan this left parenthesis, we will get dot left parenthesis dot e and right parenthesis, so we will be coming to this same state. So on left parenthesis we will be coming on the same state. Now we have successfully solved up to this much. Now moving further, when we are going to scan this t, okay, because after this dot we have a t, so when we are going to scan this t, we will be having a productions e derives e plus t dot, and we can also have t derives t dot star f. Okay, this much. Okay, now t derives dot f. Okay, so we can move from this step to this step, because when we are going to scan this f, then we will get t star f dot, and here we have the f dot. So with the transition of f, okay friends, with the transition of f, we can move from this state to this state. Okay, now f derives your dot within bracket e, so with the transition of this left parenthesis, okay, with the transition of this left parenthesis, we can reach to this state, and with the transition of this id, with the transition of this id, we can reach to this state. Okay, this much for this state. Now okay, so after this one point I am very careful, okay, that while drawing you always mention that this is a DFA. Okay, there is was a possibility that you might commit mistake when you are just solving for this production, that is t derives dot t star f, because you may think that after scanning this t we will be getting t dot star f, and here we have the t dot star f, So we can have a transition from this state to this state with T. But this is not possible, my dear friend, because this is not NFA, this is DFA. Okay? So please do remember. Now, this state has successfully completed. Now this state. With transition of star, okay, we can move from, okay, so with the transition of, sorry, we can have the transition of F. Okay, because after dot we have F. So with F, we can move from T derives T star F dot, okay, this much. Now friends, T star F dot. So F derives same with the transition of your left parenthesis, we can move from this state to this state, and with the transition of ID, okay, with the transition of ID, we can move from this state to this state. Okay, now coming to the final state. Okay, now to this state here, when we are going to scan this right parenthesis, I will be getting F derives E dot. Okay, so successfully completed this execution. Now when I will be scanning this, I will be getting E derive E plus dot T. So with the transition of plus, okay, we can move to this state because we have E plus dot T. Okay, so one left here friends, that is T derive T dot star F. So after when we will be scanning this, we will be getting T star dot F. So where is T star dot F? So T star dot F is present over here. T star dot F is present over here with a transition of star. Okay. Okay, this much. Okay. So let me check T star dot F with I9. Don't have any separation. Okay, now what you need to do, you have to name each state randomly, you can name, but it is advisable that you please name as per the state you have drawn. Okay, I6, this is I7, I8, I9, I10, I11. So we have 12 number of states. Okay, so I will be using this DFA design to construct the SLR pass table. As this diagram seems too complex, but you need not to worry about, after few classes, okay, you will be having such idea, okay, of how to solve or how to construct the SLR pass table. For the timing, stay tuned to learn it by fun. To like, share and subscribe my channel. If you have any query, do comment in the comment section. Thank you.